digestive system of human being. So in this, the digestive system of man included the various structures. So here we can see that the digestive system of human being is composed with alimentary canal, accessory digestive organs, associated glands. So these are the main three structures present in the total digestive system of human being. See that alimentary canal. Alimentary canal is a long tube-like structure, begins with mouth and ends with an anus. So between that, various organs will be present like oral cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, and anus. So these are the structures present in the alimentary canal of human being, and which is also known as gastrointestinal tract. And next structure, that is accessory digestive organs. So in this, two main structures are there, teeth and tongue. So teeth can masticate the food, and whereas tongue can release the salivary amylase. So which is helps to partial digestion of food whichever enters into the mouth. So by releasing of salivary amylase, that can undergoes partial digestion. So that is released by the tongue. And teeth are very important characters whenever the food is taken in the form of large molecules that has to be masticated. The mastication process of breaking down of food is converted by the teeth structures, and teeth and tongue are present in the accessory digestive organs. And if you come to the associated glands, so associated glands of five types in human beings, they are salivary glands, liver, gallbladder, gastric glands, and intestinal glands. So these are the structures present in the associated glands. So this is the total alimentary canal as accessory glands, accessory digestive organs, associated glands. And next, what is digestion? So digestion is a process of or conversion of complex food substances into simple absorbable food substances. So that process is also known as hydrolysis. Here, the conversion of complex food substances into their simple absorbable or that is absorbable forms, that is called as a digestion. So which is also known as hydrolysis. And here it included with anabolic process and catabolic process related reactions. So here the anabolic process and catabolic process together we can call it as metabolism. So let us see what is metabolism in further classes. And then the digestion process, how the digestion takes place in the human beings. Here some essential steps or activities are there, that is here six essential activities are there. And here we will see that, let us see what are the essential activities are there. Ingestion, propulsion, mechanical digestion, chemical digestion, absorption, assimilation, defecation. Here let us see ingestion. Ingestion means taking the food into the mouth. So that is the first step or activity associated with digestion process. Taking of food is known as ingestion. Propulsion is nothing but peristaltic movement, pushing the food into the remaining parts of alimentary canal. So that process is known as propulsion. Mechanical digestion, as we said that the teeth are very important character for the mastication. The mastication, which is also known as mechanical digestion. Chewing of food or mastication of food is also known as mechanical digestion. And chemical digestion. Chemical digestion, releasing of chemical related enzymes. By the releasing of enzymes, food will be digested. Either it is partial digestion or completely digestion. So the total process is involved by this releasing of enzymes. If the digestion takes place, the releasing of enzymes is known as chemical digestion. And next, absorption and assimilation. So after digestion of food, the absorption process will be taking place. The food which is transformed into glucose is absorbed by the intestinal structures, that is microvillus structures. The microvillus absorb the digestive food and that is assimilated to the blood. The mixing of blood and transported to the wherever it is required. That process is known as absorption and assimilation. And finally, defecation. So as we said that the digestion, whenever it is finished, after finishing of digestion, if any unwanted or undigested food molecules are there in the small intestine, that will be pushed into the large intestine. So after large intestine whenever it is received into the anus region, whenever the anus is stimulated or inspired by the anal sphincters, then the fecal matter will be released outside. So here, removal or releasing of fecal matter. Digestion. Digestion is the conversion of complex food substances into simple absorbable forms. So while taking the food may consist various types of food molecules in the form of large substances or complex food substances. So that may be composed with carbohydrates, water, proteins, vitamins, fats, minerals, etc. So this is the bulk food, which is also known as large group of molecules or complex food substances. That has to be converted into simple absorbable food. So here it is the mixture of food that is separated in the form of proteins, water, minerals, vitamins, carbohydrates, etc. This is the conversion. The conversion means here the large food substances are complex food substances which are converted into simple absorbable food substances. Here it is the mixture of food and that is separated here. That is the converting into small or simple absorbable food molecules. So this process is known as digestion. So digestion involves two processes, anabolic process and catabolic process. So anabolic process, here the simple absorbable food molecules are transformed into complex food molecules. And whereas catabolic process involves complex food molecules are transformed into simple absorbable food molecules. So together we call anabolic process and catabolic process is known as, that is, metabolism.